Hey guys, Rex here, and welcome back for some more Empyrion, Galactic Survival. Last episode, we built this awesome looking land speeder you're seeing in front of you right now. And guys, I have been busy. I have done a ton of mining here. You can see in the constructor of our land speeder, we have over 1,000 cobalt ingots. Actually, we need to make one more. And we've got 350 silicon, a whole bunch of rock dust, and a whole bunch of magnesium powder, which I really needed. All of these things I was out of. I'm pretty much out of cobalt. I'm out of silicon. And magnesium powder I'm all out of as well. And that's super important because we use it to make bullets. And we don't want to run out of those. As you can see, I made a whole bunch more. But it's really nice to have lots of magnesium so you can make some more ammo. But before we get started with what we're going to be doing today, I have news, guys. I have news. Empyrion has received its biggest patch yet, pre-alpha 3.0. And yeah, it's still in pre-alpha, like I mentioned before, so it's still very early in the development and is likely to receive even bigger patches in the future. Let's see if we can get some oxygen here. And that right there is one of the new features that they've added. They've added two massive new features in this patch. And the first one being that all the planets are now procedurally generated. Now, obviously not the ones in this world because we generated it before the patch, but all of the planets are now procedurally generated. There's random generation, there's seeds, like world seeds, and it's super awesome, guys, because that way no two worlds are going to be the same unless they obviously have the same seed, and that just makes it so much more interesting to play. The terrain is random, the ores are random, the points of interest, like that guy, are random. And I'm just super excited for that. And the second new feature is what we're looking at right there. A brand new planet has been added to the system here. And this planet is called Akua or something like that. And it's actually the new starting location. They've changed the starting... Oh, that scared me so much. Wow, I'm really wimpy, as you can probably tell when it comes to this game. Anyway, this new planet, Akua, I'm going to be calling it Akua because I don't really know how to pronounce it for sure, but that is the new starting planet. So instead of starting on Omicron, you're going to start on Akua, and Akua is actually really special because you can now press U to I'm not going to do it right now, obviously, but to take off your character's helmet. And you can see what they look like underneath their helmet. He once again looks like the stone guy that he did before one of the patches. And on Akua, you don't actually need oxygen. So you can take off your helmet, and that way your suit's oxygen will not be used, which is really, really cool. However, I am not a fan of the fact that Akua is the new starting planet, because the backstory goes something along the lines of you crashed. You crashed on this planet, and now you're stranded. And putting the crash site on a very hospitable planet just doesn't work, because if you're crashed on a hospitable planet, there's not really a problem. Whereas when you're crashed on Omicron, you're in panic mode. You've got to get oxygen and you've got to get food, or you're gonna die, right? Which is not something you want to be doing. So yeah, I really hope they did it again. I'm wasting all my oxygen here. It's really hard. The jumping in this game is really messed up. But yeah, I really think they should move it back to Omicron. But for now, we are actually still stuck on Omicron because we don't have any way of getting into space yet. So, what are we going to be doing today? Well, you'll notice that there's some holes in the front of the ship here. I also painted... Ooh, look, we've got a little damaged guy here. I painted some stripes here. I forgot to add those last episode. I hope you can see them because it is pretty dark. And they make it look a lot better. And you can see that we've got some holes here. Now, today, we are going to be putting some guns in there. And we are going to be making a little base down by the pond there so we can make... To be honest, the primary reason is to make a food processor. And that is so we can get food. Because we have all this meat here, but we can't eat it because you can see it gives us minus 15 health and minus 15 stamina. And it gives us a tiny bit of food, but we want some real food. So we need a food processor, and you can only put those in bases, which is sort of unfortunate, but I guess that's why you need to make a base, and we want to start farming. because that way we can farm some plants to make all sorts of things. Okay, so before we get started on our base here, I just wanted to blab on a little bit more about the patch, not for too long, but you may have noticed that in the top right-hand corner, they replaced all that information about the temperature and the time and stuff with the minimap, and that's really cool, because we can see all the ore deposits on the minimap. Unfortunately, they don't disappear yet when you mine all the ore in them, which is a bit annoying, because you don't know which ones still have ore and which ones don't. But also, our ships appear on it, and it's basically like a mini version of the big map, basically. And now, points of interest like the crashed ship over there, and there's some towers back there that you can't really see, those will also appear on the map too, except only on worlds that are generated after the patch, so we're not going to get those, unfortunately. But yeah, this is the big map. I didn't show that last time, but it's basically the same thing, except it's a planet, and you can sort of rotate it around. And they moved all this information here onto the map, so we can see that there's 3 minutes and 35 seconds until daytime, and it switches to nighttime afterwards. You know, it tells us the temperature, which is currently insignificant, I believe. But I do want to tell you a story, guys. Unfortunately, since this game is pre-alpha, it's still really, really buggy, but that can be fully expected of a pre-alpha game. This game is actually very, very well done for a pre-alpha game. I want to tell you a quick story. And so I was going out in my new land speeder, which is super amazing for going out and mining, and I was mining this cobalt. Whatever, you know, the cobalt that I used to have in there. And, right, so at the end of last episode, you saw that cobalt deposit that I was going mining in. So I dug a big hole, mined out all the cobalt, and I climbed back out of the hole, and I got attacked by two of those big tentacle Otyug things. And they totally ate my face, and I died. Alright, so I went back there, picked up my stuff, and then in an attempt to escape, I accidentally drove the speeder into the big hole where the cobalt was, and for some reason they made it so the booster that lets you boost out of holes doesn't recharge when you're not on flat ground, which I don't understand what the point of that is, because then you can't get yourself unstuck. And so we got our land speeder stuck in a hole, and that was really unfortunate, and I could have drilled the whole thing out, but that would have taken forever. So I just loaded it back up, and we got this guy back. So that's really good. I'm going to be loading backups probably quite often, because like I said, this game is quite buggy still, and but we can expect it all to be fixed in the future, because this game is pre-alpha once again. But, yeah. That's pretty much it. All the things I wanted to tell you about the patch. Oh, did I mention this guy? No, I didn't. This guy is the same as this little guy here. It's a new thing they've added, and it's basically a light that illuminates an area instead of a focused area like this guy. This guy they've actually changed, too. So you used to have to place him really far back, and he'd shine a beam of light, and it would be really focused, and you'd have to place him really far back, and it was a pain. They made him give less light, but in a wider arc, which is really nice, so I got to move him forward. And they added this guy, which illuminates an area, which is really nice, because these guys are a bit of a pain to deal with. But I don't believe you get any of these in the escape pod when you spawn. So, that's what this guy's for. But, what have I done here? So, I've been doing a whole bunch of crafting. It's been taking forever, as usual. And we got a base starter, which is the same as what we used to build our little speeder. We got a small generator, which is the same thing that we use as a generator, generates the power. And, you know, the same thing we've got in our speeder, except it looks different. We've got a food processor. This is the crafting station for food. There's a whole bunch of food recipes, and it's pretty crazy. And we've got a small fuel tank. This is basically the same as the fuel tank we have on there and there, but it's meant for bases. And it's a small one. There's a bigger one that's taller. And we've got a constructor that's very important, because that's like the crafting table level 2, and it lets us make a lot more stuff. And then we've got a whole bunch of blocks, and we've got some interior blocks, some ramps, and some lights. So, I'm going to build the base down by the water, like most people do, because then it's close to your oxygen station, and you don't have to walk back and forth. So I will see you over there, and let's get building. So it looks like we're finally ready to start our base after all that talking and talking. I'm sorry, guys, I love talking about patches and things. But actually, there's two more things I wanted to talk about with the patch really, really quickly. First thing is they've renamed our GV ground vessel to an HV hover vessel. And that's it. They've just renamed those because the G looked too much like a C. And the last thing is, you're seeing these guys look a bit different, and we're not seeing any of those derpy chicken guys. And that's because they moved those to, can't really see it, but they moved those to Aqua. So we're going to need to visit Aqua if we want to find those guys. But I have been doing lots of crafting, guys. I've crafted all this stuff. I'm not going to explain what it is yet. But I'm going to explain as we go. So I want to build our base in the water, because I thought that was really cool. We've actually got a new swimming animation. Let's see if we can do this. Oh, he's derping around a bit. Okay, this is the surface swimming animation. Looks a bit primitive for an animation. And then, yeah, the animations are still being worked on, obviously. But yeah, we've got a swimming animation. We can take off our helmet, but I'm not going to do that because then I'm going to drown, obviously. So let's go back in first person. Let's see, where's a good spot here? I want to build a base that has two landing pads, one for a ground vessel and one for a hover vessel. So let's do... Oh, it uses up my jetpack for some reason when I'm in the water. That's weird. So I've got the base starter, right? That's exactly the same guy that we have used to make our ground vessel starter. I want to put him... Is this a good spot? Let's... I hope it is. Okay, let's... I want to double check because I can't move this. Okay, let's do right here. Create a new base BA. Nice. Oh, I'm stuck. All right, looking good. That looks like a very good space to put it. So the first thing we're going to do, as usual, is blow up this guy because he's in the wrong spot. I literally want to move him down one block. That's the whole thing. And, okay, so I made a whole bunch of blocks here and a whole bunch of components. And I'm going to show you what those all do in a second, but I'm going to recraft the core and replace them, and I'll be right back. And we got water flying everywhere. We're taking a bath here, apparently. Beside our speeder, which is not even in the water, but somehow spraying water up everywhere. So I've recrafted the core like I said I would, and I went ahead actually and did a little bit here. We've got it sort of looks like the base of a rocket ship here. And so I should tell you about the plans for this base. So what we're going to do is we're going to have sort of like a pillar going up into like a little orb part at the top. Not really an orb, like, I don't really know how to describe it, like a squished orb maybe, but it's going to be a octagon instead of an orb. And then we're going to have ramps, as you see, to get up in here, and then out to either side from the bottom here is where we're going to have the two landing pads. And the core is actually going to go right in here because he fits nice and snugly, and actually, that seems to be working pretty good. The water is rendering it on top of the core. The last time I did something like this, the water and the core were Zed fighting, and yes, it's Zed here in Canada. So we're using these interior blocks that you can make to make sort of, you know, any floors I want to make out of these interior blocks, because I like the look of them. And then you can see we've got the same sort of texture on the ramp area, and the ramps so we can just walk up. I might put some more ramps at the bottom, like there, I don't know. But right now you have no problem because you can just swim up and then walk right in here. And then we're going to have an elevator going up the middle, but I can't actually make an elevator yet, guys. And the reason for that is because we don't have that large constructor. So we're going to start by... Oh, I really just tried to do that. I tried to hold shift and then walk off the edge, like in Minecraft. But we're gonna go out, let's say, three blocks here. And that is where... should we go four for good measure? Four? Okay, and that's where our landing pad is going to start. Now, we want to start building... Let's see, we want to have it... Okay, is there some way I can get out of the water? This is really annoying. The water physics are a bit strange, I'll tell you that. But we want to... Yeah, this is going to be the landing pad. Now, the... Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, so it became night, unfortunately, and I had to wait the 10,000 years it takes to become daytime again so I can actually record, because it's so dark at night and I don't want to turn these lights on yet because I want to show you how you do it. So, actually before we get started, I want to show you something real quick. Check this out. On the side here you see three icons. Planet, solar system, and galaxy. And that just makes me super excited. I don't know about you, but the future of this game is going to be so amazing. It looks like there's going to be solar systems and galaxies, and it's all going to be procedurally generated, and it is going to be just so awesome, guys. This game is going to be so fantastic, and it has so much potential. But let's get on to what I was doing here. So I think it's better to do this in progress updates, because then you don't see me derping around trying to place blocks and failing miserably and having to destroy half of them. So what I did here is I started on this one, and I started a bit on that landing pad too. You can see I've got an octagon pattern. If I fly up like that, oop, let's not fall off, and it did anyway. But we've got an octagon pattern here, and that's how it's going to be. So before we move on to placing the generator and stuff, come on. We want to place... Let's give this a little paint job. We're going to be going blue again, I believe. Let's see, what other colors are there? Maybe we can make it, like, white? Would that be cool? Let's see. If we just went around the outside and made this all white. Huh? Not bad? I don't think it looks bad. Let's see, I wanted to make these blue, I know that. Oh. Let's see, let's go down here too. And let's do this side. And there's a couple bits and pieces I'm forgetting from the base. Like, I wanted to have sort of angled pieces underneath there to look like it's being supported and not just, like, randomly floating. Well, yeah. Okay, so I don't think I like the white. I'm going to see if I can find a color that works. Actually, the white's not too bad, but it doesn't really contrast the gray enough here. And you can see that it's sort of angled in on the bottom. You can't really tell from here, but it's angled in on the bottom, except for right here. We've got some full blocks right here, and that's because I want to place some of these guys, some ramps. Is this facing the right way? No, it is not. Let's go turn around like this. We want to place some ramps going out here, three of them, and then we've actually got the small bit here. Goes on the end. Let's turn this around. All right, it's going to be a lot easier to get up here now. And I want to do some on the other side, too. And these are going to let us... Let's turn this around. Actually, this one. And these are going to let us drive our ground vehicle onto the pad here. So on the other pad, we don't need the ramps because we're going to be using that for a small vessel, a space vessel, so we don't really need that. So let's give this a try real quick. Come on. Oh, I'm going to take fall damage. I actually took some fall damage earlier, and you can see that my health is getting really low, so we want to get some food so we can heal up. Okay, let's give this a try. So we're going to go into third person. Alright. See if I'm fail at driving or not. Oh. Okay, looks like we need to turn a little bit. Looks good. Looks good. Alright. And... Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's on. And OCD. Okay. Looks like we have our speeders now. On the platform, which is exactly where we want it. Let's move it a bit forward. There we go. That is awesome. Now, even if we want, we can turn off the power, but I really wish there was an easy way to turn off the power but leave the fridges on, because as soon as we turn off the power and land the thing, the fridges will... they'll turn off, and then they will not work anymore, and then the food will spoil just normally. So that's unfortunate. I really wish they would add a way to fix that. But we're going to get moving here. I don't want to finish the whole base today, just maybe this little bottom part. But over here, before we, since we don't have a vessel yet, and we don't have the proper part built of the base, we're going to need to place down, let's see, where's the inventory key? Here it is. Alright, we want to place down the components here. And I haven't actually mentioned this, but when you destroy a block, you get all of the resources you use to craft that block back. So when I dig something, it doesn't look like I'm getting anything out of it, but... I'm not losing anything, except for maybe a bit of fuel, because I do have to recraft it. But we're going to put down a fuel tank and our generator right there. And we're going to load this thing right the way up. And now we can press Y to turn on the base. You can see that the lights have turned on, so we can see this thing at night. And now time for the food processor. Let's go here. And the constructor. Ha ha ha. There. Okay. So obviously we're going to move this stuff after because this is a landing pad. We don't want this here. But now you can see that we have so many more recipes available for us. We got all this stuff here, this power coils, CPUs, all this furniture stuff. And look at this, guys. Look at this. Ho, 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 ho. We can build all sorts of stuff now. And so what do I want to build right now? I want to build some doors, right? They're here somewhere. I think, yeah, right at the top. We got some doors. I'm going to build some doors for the base. I'm going to build some elevators to get up the top. And I want to build... Actually... oh, there's the turret we want to put on the hover vessel. What was I going to build? I was going to build something. Oh, yes. The Gatling guns, right? Where is it? Oh, right here. The Gatling guns, we want to build a couple of those to put on our hover vessel. So I'm going to do all that. And I will see you once again in a bit. Actually, change my mind once again. Let's do the food that's still in our thing. Let's quickly go grab it. And jetpack. Okay, we want... Let's grab three of these. We don't want to grab the whole thing yet. Okay, they go in there. This thing is really cool. You can see there are tons and tons... What the heck? Okay, that was messed up. There's tons of food recipes. Tons of food recipes. Like, all of this stuff is also slightly different, requires different things. But right now we can make grilled steak, ribs, salami, and ham, I believe. Ham, right here. And so they're all different. They're all slightly different. These ones are actually exactly the same, so I don't know why they have both of them. I guess it's just for fun. We've got salami, which gives you less stamina but has a longer perish time. So we're going to be using that. It makes a really cool noise. Well, I guess the sound is glitching out or something. I don't know why it didn't make the sound. It does make a cool sound. And the ham is used for crafting other things, so that's what ham is for. But you can see there's tons and tons of stuff, and we can make seeds here. We're going to be doing some farming in a later episode. But now that we have a good source of food, let's eat these up and regain a tiny bit of health. Nom nom nom, get lots of food and a little bit of health. And our health is still in the yellow zone, which is not good. But I'm going to craft up a couple things, and I will be right back with you. Oh, look, there's a dino. I'm pretty sure in the patch notes they said they moved them to Akua. But I guess not. Maybe they're on both. I don't know. You guys remember this guy? Remember this guy? The guy that goes boom boom? Well, thanks to our new large constructor, I have crafted 2 stacks of 120mm rockets so we can blow some things up with this guy. Super excited. We also have a whole slew of new weapons available for us to craft, and I'm just loving this large constructor in general. But there's only a couple more things we have to do before we're going to end the episode. So as you can see, I've added some lights here, and I've added these automatic doors, which are awesome. Look how cool that looks. And this is really easy to fall off of. I don't know what I'm going to do about that. And they make the coolest sound. And also added these weird frame guys in the middle. And these are elevators, and they work pretty strangely. Basically, when you're in them, you can sort of move up and down at will. It's sort of weird, I know. But that's how elevators work in this game, apparently. And the last thing we're going to do, actually the second last thing we're going to do, I promise you guys, I'd put some weapons on this guy, and I think it's time. Oh yeah. The land speeder is almost complete. We just have to put our big gun on the back. That looks so much cooler. I cannot wait to take this guy out for a spin. We're going to do that next episode, probably first thing. And yeah, all we're going to do now is rename the base, because it's still called New BA. So we're going to call this Omicron Outpost. I can't really type. Omicron Outpost. Does it work? There we go. Omicron Outpost. If it would say it. I don't know. Said it for a second there. Oh, there we go. Omicron Outpost. And we are ready, because this is not a full-size base. This is just going to be an outpost. But I hope you enjoyed today's episode, guys. I hope you are excited to see this thing in action. Pew, 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 pew. And yeah, we got a base done today. We got a large constructor, started building landing pads and this little area down here. Finally got some food. That's really nice. We got some new ammo. We got some new everything. And I'm so excited to keep doing this series, guys. So if you enjoyed this video, then please leave a like. And follow me on Twitter at NanoRexMC for more updates. But thanks for watching, guys. And I will see you next time. Rex out.